listening on Jazz FM91 or watching on Facebook Live. My name is Brad Barker. It's wonderful to be with you this evening. Tonight, live from our Long Way Performance Hall, we welcome in a very talented singer and songwriter. Tia Brazda is a name many of you are familiar with. Busting onto the scene in 2012 with her Cabin Fever EP, Tia is about to release a brand new recording called When I Get Low. So along with her all-star band and guest Alex Bird, here is Tia Brazda.
Thank you, Brad. So good to be here today. It's so good to be with my wonderful band. Thank you all for hanging out today, and especially you for coming.
Thank you for having me, Tia. Yeah. Well, thank you, Brad.
All right, let's hit it.
Into each life, some rain must fall, but too much is falling in mine. Some tears must fall, but someday the sun will shine. Some folks can lose the blues in their hearts, but when I think of you, another shower starts. Into each light some rain must fall, but too much is falling in mine.
Into each life some rain must fall, but too much is falling in mine. Into each heart some tears must fall, but someday that sun will shine. Some folks can lose the blues in their hearts, but when I think of you, another shower starts. Into each life some rain must fall, but too much is falling in mine.
Everybody.
Get out of here.
Thank you. How are you folks doing at home? Feel free to leave a little message in the chat on the Facebook. We can see who's here and all of that. We always like to know. All right. So this is the new album, When I Get Low, that we recorded as a band, but apart during the pandemic. And so we all recorded in our homes, not even quarantine in a studio or anything, but individually. And so this is the first time that we are getting together as a band and playing it in full. So yeah, pretty cool feeling, huh? Yeah. Yeah. A little enthusiasm, guys, come on. All right, so This is a collection of covers for the most part, and this one is called Lullaby of the Leaves.
Be my lullaby. Days so long ago, when I was a time so high, and now that I have grown, I found myself alone. Cradle me with summer skies and watch me with a million eyes. Oh, sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. Cover me with heaven's blue and let me dream a dream or two. Oh, sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. I'm breathing along, along with the breeze. I'm hearing a song through the trees. That my melody caressing the shore, familiar to me, I've heard it before. In my soul, and don't I know I've reached my goal? Oh, sing me to sleep, lullaby of the along with the breeze. I'm hearing a song through the trees. That kind melody caressing the shore, familiar to me, I've heard it before. That's heaven, don't I feel it in my soul? And don't I know I've reached my goal? Oh, sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. Oh, sing me to sleep, la 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 lullaby of the leaves. Thank
you. Feeling that virtual applause. Thank you, Brad. All right. So this next song is one that we've been playing live for a long time. When I was doing a residency back in like 2011 at this old bar on Queen Street called the Cadillac Lounge, which is no longer here, we used to sing this song. It's called When I Get Low, I Get High, and it's high time that we recorded it. So here we go. Thank you.
My fur coat's so dull, Lord, ain't it cold? But I'm not gonna holler, cause I still got a dollar. And when I get low, whoa, I get high. Now my man walked out, now you know that ain't right. You better watch out if I meet him tonight. Because when I get low, whoa, I get high. All the hard luck in this town has found me. Nobody knows how trouble goes round and round me. Now I'm all alone with no one to pet me, and my old rocking chair ain't never gonna get me. When I get low, whoa, I get high. All the hard luck in this town has found me. Nobody knows how trouble goes round and round me. Oh, now I'm all alone with no one to get me. And my old rocking chair ain't never gonna get me. When I get low, whoa, I get high. Oh Lord, ain't it cold, but I'm not gonna holler, cause I still got a dollar. When I get low, I get high. I said when I get low, I get high. I said when I get low, whoa, whoa, I get high.
All right.
That is Tia Brazda. And you are listening to Jazz FM 91, and Tia's playing tunes from her new album, When I Get Low. I'm Brad Barker. It's great to be with you all. I want to give a shout-out to everyone else that's in here tonight. We got Chris Adriaanse back there playing some bass for us tonight. Max Senitt, the new Juno winner back there, playing some drums. Yay. Ewen Farncombe at the piano there. Great to have you with us. Longtime collaborator on guitar, Mike Freedman. Mike, it's great to be with you. And then you've got your special guests. That's Alexis, Baro, who you hear playing that great trumpet tonight. And the most talented guy around, it's Drew Jurecka over there playing, I think, 7 instruments tonight, but he's great to have you with us as well. And we heard from Alex Bird off the top with Tia. So thanks to all of you for being here with us. Tia, it's great to see you. It's been a while.
Brad, it's been so long. How's
well,
it?
I was going to say
it's 2 years.
4 years between Daydream and the new album.
Yeah.
I know there's been some things that happened in that 4 years, but tell me, you as a person, as an artist, what has that time been like for you?
Well, the gap really brought it home, like how long I've been doing this. So I realized, you know, I had my 10-year anniversary of Cabin Fever, that release during the pandemic. I was like, what? 10 years I've been doing this. So, you know, I think a lot of people had a bit of a reckoning during the pandemic with what they wanted to do with their lives, of course. And a lot of artists especially, it was a really tough time for all of us. I guess I can say that was the case, right? Yeah, so... for me, you know, I realized more than ever that I missed it so much, and I love doing it, and I'm so happy to be back and playing for you. Hello out there. yeah, it's really good to be back. This album was actually not that intentional. It started out just to keep busy. I just wanted to do something, and I thought, Oh, I like that song. I love that song. I was just connecting with these songs as I went along, and I decided to record them as I went along. And every time I had three, I would send them to the band and be like, what do you want to do with this? So that's kind of how it
happened.
Did it
take you a while to get that momentum when things first happened, or were you kind of up and running right out of the gate? Or was it sort of a time to sort of reconsider for a bit and then like, you know what, let's go?
Well, like a lot of people, I think when it first happened, I was fretting with how do I spend my time? I signed up for all these courses. I mean, like I was on everything, you know, Coursera, like Udemy, like all of them. I took like, I'm like, I'm going to learn Photoshop. I'm going to learn how to do like, you know, pencil drawing kittens, like just kind of spending my time.
I had a lot of dreams of doing stuff too, and after 2 weeks, they all fell apart.
That's the thing, right? Yeah. So I basically went really busy in the beginning. I took a whole bunch of music courses, actually. Oddly, I studied some opera during the pandemic, and so that was a new thing to try. And in terms of writing music, I honestly didn't have a lot of motivation. I wasn't going out, of course, and it was everything just, you know, when you're going through the trauma, it was just too, I couldn't process any of it. It's like, I'll write about this later or maybe never.
Well, that sort of, that brings me to, because I think of you in some ways as much of a very unique vocal stylist as a songwriter too. And your other albums have been heavily loaded with this kind of combination of a contemporary sound, but obviously with this very traditional 20s and 30s things kind of mashed in there. Was it almost a result of that time away that said, I'm going to these tunes that are pre-written, things that I'm gravitating towards right now?
Absolutely. So I got to know these songs first as a fan and a listener, and these are the songs that I was just connecting with throughout this last couple of years. And that's sort of it. You know, I thought things that I'd always wanted to cover, like When I Get Low, for example, had always been in the back of my mind. I didn't think I would do it for quite a while. It was always like a future far-off project, but the writing wasn't coming. And I thought, you know, I need to keep recording. I need to keep studying. I need to keep learning. And I thought that learning these songs was an excellent way to grow as a vocalist. And it did help. You know, it was really like things that I wouldn't write melodically. It's just so good for me to try things in a new way. And maybe it's going to affect my songwriting approach for my next album.
I think it's interesting, too, because the new album sounds very much like you, too. So it's not like you're diverting from your kind of natural course. It's like your original music was also very sort of tied into the way that you sound here.
Absolutely. I wanted to get very comfortable with the songs, and that's also why I took a lot of time. You know, one of the challenges with doing a cover song is singing it to the point that you're so comfortable with it that it doesn't sound like a cover. Like, it should be really, you should be owning it as much as you can. And so that's what I was trying to get to before I recorded the songs. And hopefully I did them somewhat, a little bit of justice, I don't know, but it's up to you guys. And you can check out the full album. It's coming out on the 27th of this month. So it's called When I Get Low.
When more broadly, Tia, I'm wondering if you can connect why you have, whether it's this album or always your sound, why do you have this connection to this certain period? Why are you an old soul? Do you ever kind of try to analyze where that connection comes from?
Well, I think in terms of the current day context, there were a lot of parallels between the stuff that was going on when these songs were written and a lot of the things that we're experiencing now. So I feel like they're timeless, and also they sort of feel familiar to me. Like, for example, Smile. A lot of my stuff's very upbeat and sort of uplifting, I guess you could say. And I think all of these songs are sort of like that as well. And it sort of connects them all.
Well, these are your words. I'll let you answer for them. The album is dystopian thematically. The album is ultimately uplifting and dreamy with a dash of grit. so there is kind of lyrically, or the tunes that you picked do have kind of this, there's a heaviness to the two of them.
Like, they're written like during hard times. Those were hard times, like 30s and 40s. I mean, definitely. My grandmother was a young woman during that time, and she shared a lot of stories with me. And so I think maybe that's also why I feel like an affinity for that era. Feels a little bit like, grandma's house.
Well, you were going to play the album in succession, but I asked if you would give us something a little different flavor in the middle here. So I'm wondering if, and then we'll get back to finishing off the rest of the album, playing it in its entirety. But so set up this next one for us.
Okay, great. So this one's off of the album Bandshell, and we're just going to have a few of us playing on it. We're going to do Breathe Easy, guys, which, you know, sometimes it's so funny revisiting these older songs, and I feel like they're more appropriate for the current times than ever. It's bizarre. Here we go. I woke up, I got out of bed, brewed my coffee and fried my eggs. Turned on the TV, it was more bad news. Put on my jacket and I tied my shoes. I'm gonna breathe easy, let the chips fall. I'm gonna breathe easy through it all. I done all I could, I hope I did some good. But I ain't gonna worry no more, no more. I ain't gonna worry no more. Got out the door about 8:30. Hailed a cab cause I can't be late. Been stressing about facing the day. I'll be damned if I run away. I'm gonna breathe easy, let the chips fall. I'm gonna breathe easy through it all. I done all I could, I hope I did some good. But I ain't gonna worry no more, no more. I ain't gonna worry no more. Myself, I'm gonna be alright, even when I'm dodging dynamite. Tell myself I'm gonna be alright, even when I'm dodging dynamite. Tell myself I'm gonna be alright, even when I'm dodging dynamite. Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna breathe easy, let the chips fall. I'm gonna breathe easy through it all. I done all I could, I hope I did some good. But I ain't gonna worry no more, no more. I ain't gonna worry no more. I said I ain't gonna worry no more, no more. I ain't gonna worry no more. Ah, nice familiar old songs, like a warm blanket. But it's really fun to play this new stuff with you guys for the first time. My goodness. So to anyone that knows a little bit about what I've been up to, I did a couple of shows in Germany and one in London just a couple of weeks ago. But I was with part of my group here, but also some European musicians as well. So this is really the first time that we're doing these songs all together as the recording band, which is really nice. This next one is Kiss to Build a Dream On by the Ink Spots. Give me a kiss to build a dream on.
and my imagination will thrive upon that case. Sweetheart, I ask no more than this, a kiss to build a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me, and my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part, a kiss to build a dream on. When I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Give me your lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on.
True, Jurecka, beautiful, the Bandonian. So for those of you out in the audience, you can see. Very cool instrument. All right. This next one is a classic tune. I think it needs no introduction at all. Though your heart is aching, smile even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you try. Through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
your heart is aching. Smile even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile and maybe tomorrow you'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile, smile. Oh, oh, oh.
Thank you. Hello out there. How are you all doing? I hope you're leaving some comments because I'm going to go on there later. We're going to have a little chit chat. Tell me where you're from. I really want to know where you're from. So it's so wonderful to be back here at Jazz FM in Liberty Village in Toronto. And I just want to thank everybody today for making this possible. Danny Elwell, unfortunately, she's not here today. Brad Barker, thank you so much. It's just like a great reunion. And I just want to give a shout out to all the staff behind the scenes. You guys are doing an amazing job. And they have all been working so hard this last couple of years, you know, especially in moving things online and just being creative with keeping the connection with all of you going. So give them your round of applause, your virtual round of applause. We can give them a round of applause though, right? So, you know, this next one is kind of, I mean, of course it's an old song, but if you think about it in the context of now, I feel like a lot of people I know personally met their life partners and fell in love, and some even got married and had kids and all this stuff during this time. And that's kind of, I guess, what happened when they were forced to step out of going out every night. Natural progression, right? but, you know, a lot of people did. They found some good out of these hard times, and they met their one and only. And this next song is called Easy Living, all about being just the two of you. Living for you is easy living. It's easy to live when you're in love, and I'm so in love. There's nothing in life but you. I'll never regret the years I'm giving. It's easy to give when you're in love. I'm happy to do whatever I do for you. For you. Maybe I'm a fool, but it's funny. People say you rule me with one wave of your hand. Living for you is easy living. It's easy to live when you're in love, and I'm so in love. There's nothing in life but you. For you,
living for you. It's easy living, it's easy to live. When you're in love, and I'm so in love, there's nothing in life but you.
Wow, Drew, thank you. Thank you so much, everyone out there, for staying around, sticking around, not logging off. Thank you. I just want to introduce the band to you. I'm sure we will do that at the end, but I also want you to know who is giving you these beautiful sounds tonight. So Max Senitt, the most amazing drummer ever. And I just have to say that Max's band Avatar got a Juno the other night. So congratulations to Max. Yeah, amazing. Mike Freedman on guitar. Yeah. We have an original song for you a little bit later as well. Chris Adriaanse on the bass, yes, who just lugged that bass all over Germany and England. You are amazing, my friend. Up the escalators with the bass, oh my goodness. Ewen Farncombe, everybody, on piano. A new addition. So good to be with you tonight. Alex Bird on vocals for that first song. And Alex was also nominated for Vocal Jazz Album. Yeah. And Ewen as well, because you guys made that album together, right? So that was a total team effort as well, right? You're the producer and all that? Awesome. Yeah, yeah, well, he's very gracious. He was pointing at you. Drew Jurecka on all the instruments. And Alexis Baro. Yeah, Alexis, who also played at the Junos. You were in the marching for BB No Money, right? That was pretty cool. I still haven't watched the clip, but I'm going to, just for your outfit. Looks so much fun. Like, that would just be a lot of fun from the pictures you showed me. I would have liked to be there. And Brad Barker. Everyone, let's just give him a round of applause because he's awesome.
There's no reason to.
No reason. There's lots of reasons. You know what? I took an Uber here today, and the guy that picked me up, he saw the address came up, Jazz FM, and he goes, oh, Jazz FM. I'm listening to Jazz FM. And he goes, I love this show by Brad Barker. He's my favorite host.
He's got great taste.
He's listening right now.
And we played some of your music while you were in that cab, too.
He did. It was quite the nice drive to come do this. It was like a really nice omen. So, yeah, that was really great. Let's dedicate this next song to Elio and his wife, who are listening, I believe, in Oakville tonight. I don't want to set the world on fire.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In your heart I got but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of, believe me. I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. I I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't.
That is Tia Brazda, and you are listening to Jazz FM 91, and we are live from our Long and McQuaid Performance Hall, celebrating the release of Tia's new album, which is called When I Get Low. And I also want to let everyone know that Tia and the band are going to be performing for an official release party on Friday, May 27th. They're going to be at the Small World Theater, and if you want to get tickets, you can go to Eventbrite or Tia's website, which is TiaBrazda.com. Again, that's Friday, May 27th. Sounding great, everyone.
Thank you. It's live. Anything can happen. Anything.
So you sort of brushed over that, the fact that you had been in Europe just a couple of weeks ago, maybe 10 days ago.
Yeah.
A little more. I think that's a place you're familiar with. It's somewhere you have gone on other albums as well, correct?
Yes, yes. I did my first show in Europe, I believe, after the Cabin Fever release, for sure. I believe it was in 2013 that I was there. Went to London and Paris. And
how does an artist sort of find their way there? Is it serendipity? Is it hard work? Of course there's hard work, but how does it get into the people's hands that say, come on over and do a gig?
Well, the first time I went over, it was because I met a DJ that was playing a show. It was an electro swing DJ that was working in Toronto, and then was like, you got to come over. And they were very gracious. They organized an entire tour for me, like to Amsterdam, and like it was amazing. There was a lot of cool spots. And now, this time, my partner is also managing that side of things. His name's Chris Graham, and I know he's watching and listening tonight. And he does a lot of work, just, you know, reaching out to people. It's all about relationships, you know, and just who you keep in touch with and who you meet along the way. And hopefully, you know, the fans that you connect with on the road get to know new places they suggest that you should play and help bring in the audience and all of that. So it's sort of been growing over the years. And I feel that in this next couple will be there a little bit more, too.
To go from sort of being sort of shut down and being quiet to being out on the road in Europe, what kind of brain changes is all that on a plane, and we're gigging, we're running around, and we have equipment. It seems like that would be a hard adjustment right out of the gate.
I'm still adjusting. Like my voice in a monitor is weird. I like the echo of my bathroom. but you know, it was surreal at first, as surreal as this was when everything stopped. It was getting back into it again. You're like, how do we do this? And my voice was honestly really tired after the first night, because I'm just not used to doing those shows. And, you know, it's just kind of right now, I feel like I'm just getting back into the swing of things, mentally and physically. And thank you for supporting me in my return to live performance. It was definitely exciting, though. And, you know, over there, people were really coming out to the shows. They were packed, honestly. In Germany, it was, it was rocking. They were, I promise.
So in addition to all the musicians that you have here, there was also another musician that showed up on your album that isn't here tonight.
Yes, not here today.
Jason Marsalis.
Jason Marsalis, yes.
You had a Marsalis on this particular record.
Yes.
Who you got to record in New Orleans, and I think our pal Chris Butcher sort of facilitated some of that. But
yeah,
Tell me a little bit about how do you get Jason on the record, and how did it go down?
Well, we just felt that the song could use a little bit of that vibe, so to speak. And I think it was Chris that thought of asking him. And it may have been because Chris Butcher had posted something like he was working with him or something along those lines. And, you know, we're friendly and with Chris Butcher, and he's doing awesome things down in New Orleans. So, yeah, we just reached out, and Jason was totally up for it. And they recorded at a studio in New Orleans. And actually, funny enough, Alex Bird recorded his part in, I think it was a cabin in the woods with a homemade ice rink. Is that right?
Cobalt,
works for me. I'm not from Ontario, so.
So would you, if you ever made an album again, was doing it in this very crazy way something that you would ever want to do again or
no,
never
Brad.
Again?
No.
Never again.
Never. Never. I love working with these guys in person. I was just, it was hard, but we had to make it work. And we just, you know, to feed our souls, I guess, without sounding too corny. But it was true. I mean, they actually started their own group without me during the pandemic as well. I think it was short-lived. It was short-lived. What did you guys end up calling it? Anti-Shock Connection. What is it? Oh, the Clinton-Shaw connection. That works. All right. I get it. So, yeah, you know, we all had to do things to keep going during this time. And making the album how we did was what we felt we needed to do. But absolutely not.
Understood.
No. We're going to make a new one soon, get working on it, and record it together. It's going to be the most live off the floor.
Well, yeah. I recognize certainly Mike Freedman, your guitar player, because you guys have sort of worked together since the very beginning. So tell me a little bit about that relationship when you guys first met and how you connected and what were the things that you shared that made it be a successful musical partnership.
Oh, yeah, that's a great question, Brad. So I guess it would have been about, yeah, like 10 years ago. I don't remember if it was for a co-writing session or if it was because you were going to be my guitar teacher. Do you remember which one it was?
The co-writing.
Okay. And then you became my guitar teacher for a while. Or piano teacher. I don't remember. But you were teaching me something.
How was she as a student? Yeah. Can she rip it up pretty good now on the guitar?
Uh-oh. Better be nice. So, we met through a mutual friend of ours, Ron Lapata. And Ron and I had been in a project before. And I started co-writing with Mike on his recommendation. And it was just such a great, we just had a really good artistic chemistry, I would say, from the beginning. Like, I remember Thief in the Night, which is on the EP. We sat down and wrote that in like 5-10 minutes. Yeah. It was like he played the song and I sung it. It was like we already knew it. It was just a great way to kick off our songwriting relationship. Of course, we have many times where we're working very hard to get something that we like together. Doesn't always come that easy, trust me, or we would have made an all-original album as well as this. But we did manage to get together toward the end of the recording process for this album. And it was so nice to see him. I actually started crying a bit. Did you start? You may have been crying a little bit. like his eyes were getting a little bit welled up, I think. I'm teasing you. But I was definitely teary. It was just so nice to see him again. In all seriousness, it was like we lived really close to each other and hadn't seen each other in so long.
Wow.
So we sat down on his front deck and we wrote an original song and decided it had to be included in this album.
So on the new album, When I Get Low, it's all tunes, standards that we've heard, but This is the one little chestnut that you and Mike put together. So you want to favor it with us now?
Of course. Thank you so much. The world stops and you see what you're made of, building castles and chasing dreams, carried off on the breeze. When the ground moves beneath your feet, suddenly you've got nowhere to go. Is this all really happening? Can we rewind to the good times some way? Mm-hmm.
you're made of. Then you're caught up in the debris. Pray you land softly. Will our lives ever be the same? And do we even want them that way? Oh, the silence gets deafening. So I sing songs to get through long, lonely days.
All right, this very quiet room. I'm looking for those comments. David McTeague on promotions. Can you see any comments on there?
From all over.
Really? Where's the furthest comment you can see? Furthest away. No way. Very nice. Well, hello in Japan. All right. I don't even know what time it is there, but it's definitely not 7-ish. I don't even know what time it is. All right, but I think it's time for one more song. So since we were talking about our songwriting vibes, I was thinking, you know, we could do another original if that's cool. All right. How about Old Fashioned Love? Yeah, I'd love to do that one. Mike's going to switch up the guitars. All right. Well, I'll take this moment to thank all the staff here. Jelani here is assistant to the general manager, and he's been working really hard. Glenn Cross, Jason Anderson, David McTeague on promotions, and Raul Rodriguez has been doing an amazing job on the sound. Thank you so much. And yeah, it's just a really big pleasure to be back here, and I was so thrilled when I was invited to come do this and to have a way to get the album out there and connect with all of you as far away as Japan. It's very exciting. And yeah, it's great to be here. So thank you ever so much for this opportunity. Thank you. Blurring the lines in this frenzy, all my heart craves is a warm place and a safe embrace. I'm dreaming of an old-fashioned love with this old-fashioned heart just beating through me. I'm looking for an old-fashioned heart to share this old-fashioned love. So what's wrong with that? In these modern times, it's a mad dash to the next best thing. All I really want is one good catch. Oh, I don't mind the strings. I'm dreaming of an old-fashioned love with this old-fashioned heart just beating through. Looking for an old-fashioned heart to share this old-fashioned love. So what's wrong with that? We'll wine and we'll dine and we'll go to a show. Maybe share a key lime for two. We'll walk and we'll talk and our eyes will lock and we'll know that the feeling is true. Thank you.
just begin for me. I'm dreaming of an old-fashioned heart to kiss this old-fashioned love. So what's wrong with that? I said I'm dreaming of just an old-fashioned love with this old-fashioned heart just beating through me. I said I'm looking for an old-fashioned heart to share this old-fashioned love. So what's wrong with that?
That is Tia Brazda, and you are with Jazz FM 91. And before your very last tune, I want to thank all of you for tuning in tonight. And don't forget, the brand new album is called When I Get Low. It is out on the 27th, I believe.
It is.
It
yes.
is.
And we're doing a party the same night.
And same night at 27th at the Small World Theater. And you get your tickets at Eventbrite and also at Tia's website, TiaBrazda.com. Thanks to Alex, and thanks to Drew, and thanks to Alexis, Mike, Ewen, and Max, and Chris. And of course, Tia, thanks so much for sharing all of your gifts with us here tonight. Take us home with the last album, the last tune on the album, would you?
Thank you so much for having us, Brad. All right. I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. Thank you. Oh, bye. I thought you were already not there anymore. Thank you so much for listening to this very first time of us unveiling the new songs. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.